So you're actually thinking Scott did this?
I was with him from 5 o'clock on. Plus, he was in the hospital with his mother.
And neither did Bobby.
So she better get it right out of her fucking mind, because I called that bitch today.
We give her fucking information, and this is what she turns around and does?
Fucking better not, because you'll have a dead sister.
I want...
Hello. Dassy Nation is not the people that are friends of Barb or friends with Carla Chase. No. Dassy Nation is the people that really support Steven, really take care of Steven, and they really support him. The people that really thinks he is innocent. And now we have a lot of information of Selner that Bobby and Scott Tadich are involved. Of course. That's the reason that in this phone call you heard at the beginning of this video, she calls Selner a bitch. How can be Kathleen Selner, the best lawyer in the world, a bitch? No, she isn't. I think Barbara is angry with the people that are starting to say the truth. Of course. Barbara lied from the very first beginning just to protect Bobby and to protect fucking Scott Tadich. Let's see some stuff I have for you all, and then when we finish watching all the stuff and discussing it, I will ask you again, what the fuck is Dassy Nation? This is a letter from Kaczynski to Brendan. You can read it. It's amazing the way that this cat lover, this lawyer, speaks to Brendan like if Brendan was not very intelligent, or like Brendan was being coerced by his mother. And it, you know, that's true. You can see it because Kaczynski constantly mentions Barb for Brendan to know what to do or what to say, you know? I hope you are reading it all, because now, in the end, it's unbelievable, you know? He said, you need to stop thinking about who benefits from what you say and just think about what really happened. This bullshit means the opposite. Means stop thinking what happened and start thinking what could happen if you say that or that, you know? And then, if a judge or a jury thinks you are lying to cover up, you are writing yourself a sentence to a life imprisonment. Okay, if Brendan was covering up someone, he will be the rest of his life. That means, Brendan, if you know that your brother Bobby or Scott Tadich did something and you cover him up, and you will spend the rest of your life, because this sentence is not about if you are covering up Steven, because we all know Steven didn't do it, you know? So this sentence means the truth, means the reality, means Scott and Bobby. And then, if you accept responsibility for what you did and cooperate in Steven's case, that means if you say you are guilty, at least one of the whole batch will ask Judge Foch to go relatively easy on you. That's extortion. Fucking extortion. It's not fair to do this to a 16 years old boy, but the saddest thing is that this all was allowed by his mother. Of course, his mother let O'Neill make this dirty interview to Brendan, and of course, Barbara had the right to stop the interrogation or to be present in the interrogations. Another thing is the lies that she are saying. No, they didn't let me. No, I wanted to be with Brenda. No, I don't believe this shit. You are full of lies. You won't start to being true today. You are a pathological liar. So let's continue, please, because it's very hard. This is a conversation between Brendan and Steven. Sorry, Brendan and Barbara. Barbara says, face who? Brendan says, Steven. And then the mother says, I'm going to tell you something. He did it. You do what you got to do, okay? Okay, so Barbara says, there is no difference because Steven won't quit the prison, you know? It's like, you can say all the shit about Steven that you want because Steven won't do you anything. I know that the more days this channel and the more videos we have, more people from all over the world are posting comments, happy comments and truth comments about that all this shit I'm saying, it's not bullshit. It's so fucking true and I feel really sorry and I feel very bad for Barbara. But not because all the facts that I am saying, but for the horrible person and the horrible mother. I don't know how anyone can do something like the all the shit that Barbara made and did to Brenda. Well, this is still the conversation between Brendan and Barbara. Obviously, when Brendan says he's stronger than me, he's not talking about Steven because Steven could be stronger than Brendan, but Steven did no beat nobody, you know? Nobody of his family, never, ever. That's bullshit. If you open your mind and use your brain, you can see that this is about Bobby, or even he's mentioned Scott Tadich. It's plain to see, you know? It's like Brendan was very afraid with all this shit because he knew something horrible happened. And he knew that there will be people facing prison for this. He was very young and he was not ready to understand because he was just a little boy. That's why the wolves, you know, the bad guys used him to imprison Stephen Avery. It's so sad. I feel very sad with all of this. And vaccination is not the shit that so many girls and so many people are saying, bring Brendan home, and they take pictures with Barbara, and they don't wanna talk about what's happening now. Bobby fucking planted the car. Bobby chased Teresa with Scott Tadich. Bobby's alibi is Scott. Scott's alibi is Bobby. It's ridiculous. Them both are guilty. That's why they use themselves as alibis, because that's the only way to look like they are innocent, but they aren't. This is about the computer. In this, you will see that Brendan was being coerced for so long time, because even Brendan's mom, Barbara, used the computer to chat with Brendan's friends. It's March, 4th March, and she says, Brendan is not a bad person, his uncle is. Someday Brendan will know the truth, and I hope, I pray to God that Brendan open his eyes and see you for what you are, a spider. Here in this picture, at least Carla knows that there is a camera, and Carla tried to smile a little bit. But can you see Barbara's face? Barb's face? It's amazing. It's like her watching, her eyes are like empty. I don't know if she has feelings, but if she has, it will be a lot of love, because Barbara is a woman of love. She loves Scott Tadich, and she really loves his sons, Brian and Bobby. She's angry now with Brad and Blaine. She's angry with the people that no longer wants to be like her minion, you know? She has minions. She believes she's a commandant or a captain, and she has like an army. Tracy Keogh, Carla Chase, Rebecca Nash, Julie Pompon. But you know, I don't buy this shit. Vaccination is Blaine, Brad, and all the supporters that really loves Brendan and wants that the truth about Bobby, the truth about Scott Tadich comes out, because that's the only way to exonerate Brendan, to find the killer, to find the murderer, to find the people involved on the framing of Stephen Avery. That's the only way to exonerate Brendan. And if you love Brendan, you have to understand it. you have to understand that his mother is doing everything that she can for Bobby don't go to jail, for Scott Tadich don't go to jail. Do you really think Barb cares about Brendan? I think she cares about Bobby Scott. And that's plain to see.
That motherfucker answered some fucking questions.
Yeah.
Fuck Stephen Cambridge. He is a piece of shit. He's been all his fucking life.
Shut up.
Let me talk to the cocksucking loser.
Yeah.
Fuck Stephen Cambridge. The only evidence they got is against him, and he's trying to get out for her to blame it on somebody else.
Yeah.
He's a fucking loser. I wasn't even on that fucking property that day. You're a goddamn idiot.
Yeah.
That's how fucking intelligent you are.
Yeah.
You lie to yourself so you get out and do something stupid again, you dumb fuck. Hey, man, why don't you get out?
Yeah.
Fucking ass, fucking motherfucker.
Yeah.
Fuck Stephen Cambridge.